In this illustration, we'll study about the oscillations of a half ring. Here we are given that a half ring of mass m and radius r is hanged from one of its ends from point O, and it is free to oscillate in vertical plane. And we are required to find the period of a small oscillations of this half ring from its equilibrium position. Here, in this situation, we can consider this whole system as a compound pendulum. Here, if we redraw the figure, we can see if this is the diameter of half ring and this is the ring. And at point O, it is hinged. And obviously, in free suspension, it is suspended in a way that its central mass is vertically below the point of suspension. So, if this is the distance of central mass of this half ring from its center C, then we know the value of RC is equals to 2R by pi, that is the distance of central mass of a half ring from its center. And say if central mass is at a distance L from the point of suspension, then we can say for a body oscillating as a compound pendulum, its time period of oscillation we can write as 2 pi root of I by mgl, where L is the distance of center of mass from point of suspension and I is the moment of inertia. In this case, for half ring, moment of inertia about point O is, this we already studied in the concept videos of moment of inertia. So, that can be directly written as 2mr square, as we have studied in rigid body dynamics, that for a complete ring, if it is divided into two identical parts, so the expression of moment of inertia remains same. So, here we can see the time period of oscillation can be given as t is equals to 2 pi root of this is 2 mr square divided by mg, the distance of central mass from suspension point L we can write as root of r square plus rc square, which is r root of 1 plus 4 by pi square. If we substitute, this r root of 1 plus 4 by pi square. On simplifying, the value of this time period we are getting is, this one r also gets cancelled out and the mass gets cancelled out. So, this will be under the root 2 pi r divided by g root of pi square plus 4. That will be the final result of this problem.